Hello friends! In this video, we will take a look at a wireless button from the Tuya Smart ecosystem, operating via zigbee. At first glance, the device seems quite basic and has many analogs, some of which I have covered in my reviews. However, in this case, there is one significant difference. This model can operate in group mode, sending commands directly to devices within the same group, even when the gateway is disconnected. More details will follow, but for now, as always, I ask you to like this video so that more people interested in smart home topics can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Device type, wireless button. Interface, zigbee 3.0. Power source, CR2032 battery. Operating modes, scene mode, group mode. Dimensions, 45 by 14 millimeters. Operating temperature range, minus 10 to plus 45 degrees Celsius. Relative humidity, no more than 90%. The device is supplied in a small cardboard box with a sticker indicating the model number, C3006. The package includes the button itself, a plastic holder for the battery, in my case, the battery was not included, a piece of double-sided tape, and a small instruction manual. Here's everything written in the manual. One side is in English, and the other side is in Chinese. Among other things, it states that switching between scene and group modes is done by triple-clicking the button, similar to wireless dimmers I've reviewed earlier. The button has a classic round shape. Only the central part, highlighted by a blue circle, can be pressed, not the entire top surface. The thickness is just 14 millimeters, thinner than most analogs. On the sides, there are grooves that allow you to remove the back cover of the case. Underneath, there is a battery compartment and a reset button, which is used to switch to pairing mode. To do this, hold it until the LED, which I will show a bit later, starts blinking. As I mentioned earlier, in my case, the battery was not included, which was specified in the product description. By the way, I bought the button during a sale for less than $3. Therefore, I used my own battery, installing it into the included holder. The holder is necessary so that the battery can be removed from the mount, as it is held very tightly. While installing it properly, I even slightly deformed the holder. For comparison, here it is next to other buttons, from left to right. The reviewed model, Sonoff, Xiaomi, Acura. It is relatively large in diameter and pressing area, but at the same time, it is one of the thinnest among those compared. The activity LED is hidden under the blue rim on the front side. Let's move on to exploring the device's features. We'll start with the standard control system, Tuya Smart. To connect, a gateway is required. In my case, it's a wired version with Homekit support. On the gateway, activate the mode for connecting new devices, then hold the internal button near the battery until the LED starts blinking. After a short wait, the button connects to the system. As I mentioned, this button has two operating modes, scene mode, where it is used as a trigger for events when pressed, and group mode. Switching is done by triple-clicking the button. The appearance of the plugin also changes. In group mode, it's called remote dimmer. Let's first look at the scene mode. At the bottom of the window, there is a button to create scenes. Triggers can be single press, double press, or press and hold events. Select the desired type and create a new scene. Then, you can choose the task that will be executed when the button is pressed. For example, you can control other devices connected to Tuya Smart, whether they use Zigbee, Wi-Fi, or Bluetooth. All are supported. The general settings menu includes standard options. Adding a shortcut to the home screen, device information, firmware version check, and removal from the system. In the automation menu, the same options are available as in the plugin itself. The button can be used in the if section to create three types of events, single press, double press, and press and hold. A special feature of this device is its ability to work in group mode. I've demonstrated this earlier in my reviews of wireless dimmers and zigbee remotes, links in the description. Since the button is an end device, when adding or removing it from a group, you need to wake it up by pressing it. Groups can only include zigbee devices connected to the same gateway. For this test, I specifically connected a zigbee bulb to the gateway, which I added to the group. Other lights in the system are controlled via Wi-Fi and cannot be added to the group. In this mode, A single click toggles the state of devices in the group, turning them on or off. A long press adjusts brightness. The feature works but is not very convenient, as you have to hold the button for a long time, and brightness changes alternately. In this case, a wireless dimmer is much more convenient and practical. But the main point is something else. Here's the gateway to which both the button and the bulb are connected. It is completely disconnected from power and the network. Yet, control continues to work as before. This is the essence of direct binding and group mode. Devices communicate directly. In this case, the button sends events to its group, and all devices in the group respond. The gateway supporting HomeKit allowed integration with Home Assistant via the corresponding integration. The original application works the same way. The button appears in the system, showing the type of the last event and how much time has passed since it occurred. For example, here's a double press event. A key point is that events are generated in the same way in both scene and group modes. The button can simultaneously control devices in its group and participate in scenes. Here's a long press event. It is generated after holding the button for 3 to 4 seconds. This works in parallel with Tuya Smart and the group. Here's an example of creating an automation trigger in Home Assistant based on the events generated by this button. This is how it looks in text form, which may be useful for those who prefer using packages, as it is more convenient for data organization. Now let's disconnect the button from the gateway and test compatibility with the smart home control hub, Sonoff iHost. The firmware version used for testing is 2.4.0. After launching the connection mode, the button appears alongside the cameras that iHost detected on my network. It is assigned an icon for a 4-button wireless switch. This is how its tile appears in the general list. In the upper right corner, the letter E indicates that it's an end device. When you click on it, you can see the battery level, type, and time of the last event. In addition to the three types of events we've already discussed, there are two more, on and off. The first appears immediately after a double press, and the second after a long press, essentially duplicating them. The general information menu only includes standard options, with no additional settings. As of the testing date, zigbee group functionality is not yet supported here. The button can be used as a trigger for automations to initiate various actions. While many types of events are supported, in practice, only the same three types of presses mentioned earlier can be effectively used. Now let's return to Home Assistant, but use an alternative coordinator. I have a USB zigbee stick with the EFR32MG21 chipset and SkyConnect firmware installed, review link in the description. The button was detected, and the system identified several entities. Let's examine them in detail. Apart from hidden technical entities, three objects were identified: firmware version, battery level, and identification. Presses are registered as events, as seen in this example of a single press. This is how a double press appears. Interestingly, it is registered regardless of whether the button is in scene or group mode. And this is a long press event, long click. This allows the device to be used in automations, though I personally find status changes more intuitive than events. Here is the list of events available in the trigger section for Home Assistant automations when using the ZHA integration. Now let's look at group functionality. To do this, you need to create a group. Click the configuration button. Next, go to the Groups tab. Click the button to create a new group. Enter a name. The identifier can be skipped as it is set automatically. It is only specified manually in cases like those described in the review of the multi-zone remote, link in the description. Below, select the devices, in this case, the button and the bulb. Remember to wake up the button by pressing it during the group creation process. The group is now created. Later, you can add or remove devices from it. When using multiple such buttons or dimmers, separate groups need to be created for each. Everything works exactly as demonstrated during testing with Tuya Smart. A key point, especially for the button, is that groups can include not only lights. For example, here's a Xiaomi Zigbee socket, the very first version. I specifically chose the oldest available socket, around 7 years old, using the Zigbee 1.2 protocol. I go to the previously created group, which includes the bulb and button, and add the socket. Done. Now the button will control both the bulb and the socket. Let's test it. The bulb and the socket, into which I plugged a power adapter with a USB lamp, are now controlled by the button. For such use cases, like sockets, relays, or duplicating Zigbee switches, the button is more convenient and affordable than a dimmer. However, if you want to control smart lights, a dimmer is better suited for adjusting brightness and color temperature. Now let's move on to Zigbee 2 MQTT. The version used for testing is 1.42.0 with a Zigstar network coordinator based on the CC2652P module using firmware from December 26, 2022. I haven't updated it since it works very reliably. The button was recognized correctly, even with a realistic image, identified as model ZG101ZL, an end device. On the expose page, there's an action entity whose status changes depending on the type of press, along with battery level, current operating mode, set to group mode here, and signal quality. Here's scene mode. To switch to it here, you first need to wake the button by pressing it, but in this case, it's probably easier to triple press it to switch modes directly. All these entities are displayed in Home Assistant through the MQTT integration. Unlike ZHA, button presses are registered in the system as status changes for the action sensor, rather than as events. Here's a single press. I intentionally switched the mode to group mode, but this didn't affect the status, it's still a double press. Here's the status generated when the button is held down. Groups in Zigbee 2 MQTT are created in the corresponding tab. The principle is the same as before. Give it a name. The ID can be skipped since it is automatically assigned starting from 1. However, my advice is to assign IDs manually and make them longer, as shown here for the dimmer group. Some devices are pre-configured with short group IDs at the factory, which might cause your button to control the wrong devices. Next, go to the group and select the button in the list of devices. The endpoint is the first one. After selecting the option to add it to the group, press the button to wake it up, ensuring everything works correctly. I also add the bulb here. Since it is a router, there's no need to wake it up. It will appear in the group immediately. Everything works as demonstrated earlier. One more note about Zigbee 2 MQTT. The created group, once devices like lights, relays, or sockets are added to it, will appear as another device in the MQTT integration. This allows you, if necessary, to control the entire group from both the Home Assistant interface and through automations. If this entity is unnecessary, it can simply be hidden. I purchased this button with a very specific purpose in mind, controlling emergency lighting with standalone power. I've covered this in a separate video, link in the description. This lighting setup uses a relay. This is the channel I needed, with 2 in total in a group with the button. I also use dimmers for LED controllers and strips with adjustable brightness. Here's how it looks mounted on the wall, in a convenient location. While my smart home server is equipped with backup power, and emergency lights are controlled through automations tied to open and motion sensors, an additional method of control independent of both the server and the coordinator is always useful. That's all for now. I hope you found this video helpful and interesting. I'd appreciate your likes, they help promote it on YouTube. In the description, I'll leave links to stores where you can order this gadget, as well as links to my Telegram channels, social networks, and discussion groups on smart home topics. Join in. It'll be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to all.